Did you know that today the majority of internet traffic is encrypted using Transport Layer Security, or TLS for short? Customers with security requirements to perform deep packet inspection, or DPI, need the ability to decrypt TLS traffic as it traverses the perimeter firewall and enters their virtual private clouds, or VPCs. However, the lack of visibility into encrypted traffic presents a challenge to organizations that don't have the resources to decrypt and inspect network traffic. TLS encryption can hide malware, conceal data theft, or mask data leakage of sensitive information, such as credit card numbers or passwords. Additionally, TLS decryption is compute intensive, and cryptographic standards are constantly evolving. I'm happy to share that this ability to perform deep packet inspection on TLS encrypted traffic is now possible with AWS Network Firewall. Because Network Firewall is an AWS managed service, the bandwidth performance of 100 gigabits per second per firewall endpoint is not impacted, even after you enable TLS inspection configuration. And with Network Firewall, you can choose which traffic to decrypt by using your available certificates in AWS Certificate Manager, and then applying the TLS configurations across the stateful rule groups, thereby authorizing Network Firewall to act as a go-between. I'm excited to demonstrate the configuration for you today. Now, there's three main architectural patterns for Network Firewall deployments. The first, as you see here, is a distributed deployment model in which Network Firewall is deployed into each individual VPC. The second is a centralized deployment model in which Network Firewall is deployed into a centralized VPC for east-west traffic, or VPC to VPC, or north-south traffic, inbound and outbound from internet or hybrid on-premises use cases. And the final architecture is a combined deployment model. This is where Network Firewall is deployed into a centralized inspection VPC for east-west or VPC to VPC traffic flows, and a subset of north-south on-premises or egress traffic. Now, internet ingress is distributed to VPCs that require dedicated inbound access from the internet, and Network Firewall is deployed accordingly. Each of these architectures is valid for TLS inspection functionality. Now, prior to TLS inspection configuration, here's what happens. The ingress traffic enters the VPC. Ingress routing enables the internet traffic to be inspected by AWS Network Firewall. Traffic is passed from the firewall endpoint to the Network Firewall, and Network Firewall inspects the packets first through a stateless engine. Network Firewall makes a drop-pass decision by applying the rules that are present in the stateless engine. Now, if there's no match on the set of stateless rules present, the traffic is then forwarded to the stateful engine. And again, a drop-pass decision is made by applying the set of stateful rules. If the decision is to pass traffic, then the firewall endpoint present in the firewall subnet sends the traffic to the customer subnet through the routes present in the VPC subnet route table. Now, here's what happens after TLS inspection configuration is enabled. Notice how the traffic flow changes slightly. Since the ingress data that you want to inspect is encrypted, it first needs to be decrypted before it's sent to the firewall stateful engine. So the traffic flow looks like this. The ingress traffic enters the VPC. Ingress routing enables the internet traffic to be inspected by AWS Network Firewall. The traffic flows from the firewall endpoint to the Network Firewall. Next, Network Firewall inspects the packet first through a stateless engine. Network Firewall makes a drop pass decision by applying the rules that are present in the stateless engine. And if there's no match on the set of stateless rules present, the traffic is then forwarded to the stateful engine. However, here's where things change in our traffic flow. With no match in the stateless engine and before the traffic passes to the stateful engine, if the traffic is in the scope of the TLS encryption configuration, the traffic is forwarded for the decrypt operation. After decryption, the traffic is then forwarded to the firewall stateful engine for inspection. Again, Network Firewall makes a drop pass decision by applying the set of stateful rules. The traffic is then re-encrypted. If the decision is to pass traffic, then the firewall endpoint, present in the firewall subnet, sends the traffic to the customer subnet through the routes present in the VPC subnet route table. And for this to work, you have to trust the certificate. So now that we know how DPI and TLS inspection works, let's look at how we configure it in the AWS console. And here we are in our AWS console. The first thing I'm gonna do is click Create Firewall. There's gonna be three elements. It's gonna have a firewall configuration attached to a firewall policy that refers to rule groups. So we're gonna have to go through a couple of items of information here. So we're gonna say this is gonna be our AWS firewall demo. And we can just copy that. And a couple spaces there. We need to choose the VPC where we're going to create this firewall, and it's going to be in our network firewall VPC. We're going to choose the US West 1A availability zone. We're going to then pick the subnet where our endpoint is going to be deployed. And so that's going to be in our firewall subnet. And then the IP address type, this is going to be IP version 4. The next thing we're going to do is set up our associated firewall policy. So I'm going to go ahead and create and associate an empty firewall policy. So I'm going to call this TLS FW demo policy. And we can just copy and paste that. The rule order, we're going to leave it set to the default, and we can leave our change protections on if we want to. The first protects the firewall against being deleted. I don't really need that. It's just a demo environment. And then subnet change protection, I don't need to enable that as well. So we're going to click on Create Firewall. And now we're provisioning our firewall, and this will include our VPC endpoint, our firewall endpoint, that's going to go in that firewall subnet. So we're going to give this just a moment to provision. Okay, so our firewall status is ready. When we look at our associated firewall policy rule groups, we see that it's going to forward to the stateful engine after it looks at the stateless. And then we're going to go into the stateful rule evaluation. And I don't have any rule groups here yet. And we're gonna add some rule groups that I already have created. My stateless rule group is just gonna allow me ICMP, it's gonna let me ping to that server to verify connectivity, and then my stateful rule group is what's gonna allow the TLS and so on. If I look at my firewall details, again, I'll see my policy. So here's my firewall policy, here's my associated VPC and my firewall subnet. And we'll go ahead and set up logging here real quick. We're going to alert, and we're going to send it to a CloudWatch log group, and then we'll just send it to our network firewall demo firewall log group that we already have created, but I just like to have my logging configured ahead of time. Okay. What I need to do is I need to enable my TLS inspection, and the reason I need to do this is because I can't apply TLS inspection to an existing firewall policy. So I'm gonna go TLS inspection configuration, we're gonna enable it, we're gonna add a certificate, and I've already imported the certificate that we have installed on the server that was issued from a public SSL provider or TLS cert provider. So we have that certificate imported in AWS Certificate Manager or ACM. So I'm gonna import that, click on next, we'll give it a name, inspection, and we'll put a space there for the description. And then we're going to define the scope. Now this is defining what the firewall is supposed to decrypt for inspection. So any source to any destination, but rather than do any port, we're only going to do port 443 because that's where we expect to see our TLS traffic. Okay, so we'll go ahead and set that up. We're gonna click on Add Configuration. That scope was then added. And then we'll click on Next. We're gonna leave the KMS key configuration at its default values. Click on Next. We're not gonna add any tags. We'll click on Next. We get to review the configuration and click on Create TLS Inspection Configuration. And now we have a TLS inspection configuration that we can attach to a policy. Again, the policy has to be a brand new policy. We cannot attach it to an existing policy. So let's just go look at my rule groups real quick. Here's my two rule groups. There's a stateful rule group and a stateless rule group. Let's take a look at the stateless. The stateless rule group is allowing ICMP traffic. We can see that's a pass. And then if we look back at our stateful rule group, our stateful rule group makes use of Cerakota rules. We see those here. And we're passing both HTTP and TLS traffic to our demo website. And then we're denying any other TCP traffic. Okay? So those are the firewall rule groups that are already created. Let's go to the firewall policies. Now here's the TLS firewall demo policy that was created when I set up that firewall. So if I look at this and I look at my TLS inspection configuration, there's nothing configured. I can't add a TLS inspection configuration to a policy that was created. Now this policy was created when I set up the firewall. So what I need to do is I need to make some adjustments to my firewall policy that's attached to the firewall. So I'm going to create a brand new firewall policy. I'll call this TLS inspection policy. And we'll do a space there and a space there. And we can just leave that at the default. We'll click on Next. We're going to leave the stateless default actions alone so that after we look at the stateless rules, we forward to the stateful engine. And then for the stateful rule evaluation, we're going to change the rule order to default. We'll let the rules engine determine the evaluation order of the rules. And then we're going to come here and we're going to add a stateless rule group. And that's going to be the rule group that we just looked at. And then we're going to add a stateful rule group. And that's going to be the stateful rule group that we just looked at. We're going to say Next. We're not going to do any KMS key configuration, so we'll click Next. Now we're going to add that TLS inspection configuration that we just built. So we'll add that to this firewall policy. We're going to not add any tags. We review, and then we click Create Firewall Policy. So now we have two policies, our TLS firewall demo policy, which was created when we built the firewall in the first place, and our TLS inspection policy, which we just created from scratch. And now we need to go replace the policy that's attached to our firewall. So I'm going to go back to firewalls. I'm going to pick that AWS firewall demo. We're going to come down here to our firewall details. Here's our associated policy, TLS firewall demo policy. We're going to click on edit. And we're going to come down to the associated policy and we'll change it to the policy with TLS inspection. So now we have the rule group attached with TLS inspection and it's associated to the correct VPC. Let's just take a look at our route tables and make sure that our route tables all look the way that they should look. So if I go here to route tables, I have my protected route table. And if I look at the routes in my protected route table, I don't have a default route to go anywhere. So I need to edit my routes. And I need to add a default route, and I need that default to go to my firewall endpoint. So to go there, we pick Gateway Load Balancer Endpoint, and we pick that BEAF endpoint. So my firewall endpoint makes use of the Gateway Load Balancer endpoints. Okay, so I'm going to save my changes there. So now I'm pointing to the right place. My subnet associations are the protected subnet, so all of that looks good. Now let's go back to our route tables again. Let's take a look at our Internet Gateway routing table, or IGW route table. If I look at my routes there, 10.0.0/16 is local, but I don't have a route from the internet gateway into the firewall VPC. So I'm going to edit the routes here, and I'm going to add a route to 10.0.0.0/24, and I'm going to end up sending this into that same endpoint. Okay, so that's routing into the firewall VPC. The protected is routing into the firewall VPC. And then let's take a look at one more route table, and that's going to be our firewall routing table. I look at my routes there. It's got a default route to the IGW, which is correct. The only other thing I need to look at is my subnet associations. And if I edit my subnet associations, this should be associated with the firewall subnet, and I'll save that. Okay, so at this point, we should have connectivity through the firewall. We should be allowing ICMP, and we should be allowing TLS inspection, and it should be able to inspect it. So let's go over to our terminal, and let's just see if from the outside, we have ICMP connectivity going through that first step, which is those stateful rules. And here we are on our terminal. We're just going to hit ping. And we have ICMP connectivity at this point to our demo environment. So we'll stop that. Now let's go ahead and open up a web browser and let's see if our web browser has connectivity. Okay, so here we are in a private tab in Firefox, and we're just going to paste in the URL for our demo site and hit enter. And we are connected to that demo site. Connection is secure. If we go to more information, we now see the certificate, and we can see that it is verified by a public SSL provider, TLS certificate provider. And we could go in and we could view that certificate in more detail, and we could see the details of it if we wanted to. Okay, so let's go ahead and close this. Let's go back to our AWS console. Now that we're back at our AWS console, let's go down to our firewall. There's our firewall demo. And if we scroll down and we select monitoring, we can now see those stateful packets that are coming into the firewall, and those packets were passed. Well, there you have it. A simple configuration for an extremely powerful capability. Now, as we mentioned in the onset, deep packet inspection has been a challenge for many customers due to the fact that it's process intensive and other advanced features that many network perimeter firewalls perform. However, that's not the case with AWS Network Firewall. As we've demonstrated, the configuration is simple, and once enabled, you'll have the visibility into TLS encrypted traffic that you need. Please check out the links in the description to learn more. Thank you for watching this feature demo video.